So this is the slinky spiral scene. It happens early in the film and sort of pushes Max along the way to sort of seeing spirals everywhere. I was looking for another connection between little Jenna and Max, and I wanted to find a toy that sort of pushed Max along on his journey, and the slinky was just the obvious choice. And it's kind of funny because this is the image that we pulled for press, and probably the image that most people associate with pie. This is the infamous Farouk beatdown scene, starring the uniquely talented Ajay Naidu. It didn't quite work for pacing, so it ended up being a victim of the cutting room. And Farouk's character was created to increase the intensity and fear and paranoia of Max Cohen, but we sort of realized quickly that Sean had enough to be afraid of, and so we didn't have to increase it as much as we thought we did. He's a great talent, though, Jay. And there's Max's little revenge. This is the Ubermensch sequence that we cut out for pacing reasons, but basically it was used to set up where Max got his computer parts from, and this is our sort of low-budget attempts at a mega computer dump. It's actually just all the unused parts that didn't make Euclid. It's right outside the lighting factory. You can see color footage of this and the behind-the-scenes footage. But that's Max trying to get parts. This was a camera test for what we called then at the E3 cam and finally became known as the snorrie cam. The rig is attached to Sean's body, and it just sort of created this great subjectivity for us. We were trying constantly to stick the audience into Max's head. We wanted to tell the point of view of Max's brain in 90 minutes of pie. This was the first time we tested it out. It's a long shot. I just told Sean to go have fun in the bodega and play a little bit of Max Cohen, and Chris B was handling the camera. If you look closely right towards the end of the take, Max sort of ran into a bunch of Hasids that were checking him out and almost cracked a smile. And that little piece of Snickers bar didn't fall off of his chin either.